Hi, I'm Sandie Barrie Blackey, Chief Knowledge Officer of Lexercise. I'd like to talk with you today about developmental dysgraphia, its diagnosis and its treatment. We get a lot of questions from parents who are worried about their kids' handwriting or written language. Here's a classic example of the writing of a dysgraphic student. This student, age 8 in third grade, had a high IQ and reading scores in the average range, but his writing sample was illegible. We'll be revisiting this example as we move forward because it's such a classic example of dysgraphia. But first, let's review a bit about dysgraphia. The prevalence estimates for dysgraphia are extremely varied, from soup to nuts, mainly due to the differing definitions of dysgraphia. Developmental dysgraphia, that is, dysgraphia that's not due to an illness or an accident, is difficulty acquiring written skill despite sufficient learning opportunity and cognitive potential. Decades ago, dysgraphia was thought of as a disorder of fine motor eye-hand coordination, but it's now considered to be a language processing difficulty related to inefficiencies in how the brain's language literacy centers are interconnected across, you might say, ear, eye, mouth, and hand. You can see the interconnections of language processes in this writing sample. While the student's scores were in the average range for reading, his writing was largely illegible. He had some letter formation problems for sure, but the main reason his writing was so hard to read is related to spelling. He read his story, thankfully, because we couldn't read it ourselves, as follows. It was in the Ice Age. They were throwing spears at an elephant and stabbing it. Notice his spelling of the word elephant. It's safe to say that if he were typing, spell check would not recognize this word. His spelling errors reveal speech sound and alphabetic awareness difficulties. While he scored in the average range on end-of-grade tests, his parents were worried about his writing. A language processing evaluation revealed symptoms of both dyslexia and dysgraphia. While his dysgraphia was easy for everyone to see, his reading issues were harder to notice, but in-depth testing revealed his struggles of both reading and writing. Reading and writing, after all, are very interconnected. Dysgraphia is typically described by a cluster of symptoms involving letter formation, spelling, sentence conventions, and conveying ideas in writing. The term dysgraphia is typically not used to describe students who have cognitive deficits or disorders of intellectual development. Here's a long list of symptoms commonly seen in dysgraphia. I'll pause a moment to let you read through these. One of the things that's often confusing to parents is the use of different classification systems and terminology, those used in healthcare versus education. A diagnosis is typical in private evaluations, such as those done in healthcare settings, but in public schools, in the USA at least, the result of an evaluation is typically not a diagnosis per se, but a classification for purposes of determining the student's eligibility for exceptional children's programs. In private evaluations, students with dysgraphia are diagnosed as having a disorder of written expression, whereas in public schools, they're categorized as having a specific learning disability. The word dysgraphia is not used as a diagnosis per se, but instead as a descriptive term to further define the diagnosis. For example, a disorder of written expression with symptoms of dysgraphia. Okay, let's talk a bit about treatment for dysgraphia. Effective treatment for dysgraphia starts with an analysis of the potential sources of breakdown in the brain's literacy network. Potential sources of breakdown include any of the components of written discourse, including letter formation, spelling, and sentence conventions. When there is a disruption in these transcription skills, a disorder of written expression or a specific learning disability may be further described as dysgraphia. Here is our classic dysgraphic student's writing before starting intervention. Spelling accuracy was 29%, with only 5 probably memorized words spelled correctly in the at, and, and it. The student had 15 minutes to write this story from a picture prompt, and he was only able to write 2 sentences. After 7 months of structured literacy intervention, he wrote this story, again, given a picture prompt in 15 minutes. Notice that while his letter formation was still labored, every word is readable. Spelling accuracy is dramatically improved to 89%. Now, spelling errors are limited mostly to homophones, like at the end of the first line, T-H-E-I-R spelled T-H-E-R-E, and at the beginning of the last line, C-O-A-L spelled C-O-L-E. Through structured literacy intervention, his speech sound awareness has been strengthened to support much more accurate spelling. After 8 months of intervention, this 15-minute writing sample demonstrates how much the use of keyboarding helped by relieving labored letter formation, facilitating self-correction, and enabling the use of more advanced vocabulary and higher quality writing overall. I'll pause here briefly so you can read this. But note, without the 7 months spent using structured literacy intervention, his writing would not look like this, because his main problem in the beginning was spelling, and his spelling was so far off that spell check would have been no help. While keyboarding can help and is surely an important skill in a digital age, handwriting is still important. Research supports the superiority of handwriting for many academic tasks and its support for memory. So, it was the focus of the last month of intervention, focusing on the hand's movement pathway for forming each lowercase letter. His handwriting became more automatic, fluent, and he told us enjoyable and useful. Here's a thank you note he wrote his football coach. If you're concerned that your student may have difficulties described as dysgraphia, you can complete this free online screening questionnaire to help decide if the student's symptoms are described as dysgraphia. The International Dyslexia Association, IDA, has knowledge and practice standards for assessing and treating disorders of written language. Professionals who have certification from the Center for Effective Reading Instruction, or CERI, have passed an exam demonstrating their knowledge and skills in those standards. IDA-accredited professional education courses are available. I've included 2 pages of references and 1 page of resources for your further study. Thanks so much for your interest in how to help students who struggle with dysgraphia.